whichever you use, flex or rigid, make sure you design the system, make sure that you test the system, and then make sure you have some adjustability on that system so that if the actuals doesn't meet the designs, you're able to do something about it. Howdy y'all, it's Jordan Smith. I'm a design builder with Smith House Company, where we believe houses should be beautiful, functional, resilient, and healthy. Today, I'm in a house that I did not build. It's a spec house in a very nice part of Austin. It's a nice house. It has flex duct ran for all of the ACs. And if you've seen some of my past videos, you know that I think that flex duct, when installed correctly, is a fantastic product. It will work fine. However, rigid duct does have the secondary benefit of if you run rigid, you have to make sure that it fits through all of the holes that you cut for the rigid. You can't cram it through something really small and pinch it off like you can on flex duct. Inversely though, you run on flex duct from the plenum all the way to your register in a direct home run. You don't have a lot of Y's and branches and seams that you have to mastic. So it all comes down to the installation quality. Having said all of that, I was up here in this house and I was doing a different video on dehumidification, and I was looking at the ductwork and I was like, man, this doesn't look that bad to me. It's all strapped up. The plenums have plenty of space in them. It looks like a good flex duct install. So at first I was going to do this is how you do flex duct right. But then I asked the owner, I was like, hey, that flex duct looks pretty good up there. What's been your experience? He's like, let me tell you my experience with this flex duct. And he started showing me a bunch of pictures of the install where this flex duct was ran specifically over to a bedroom behind y'all over there. It was ran and it was crossed and it's clearly pinched off. And then when they moved into the house, they found out that that west facing bedroom just didn't get enough air into it, and they can't do anything with just at the registers shutting off the little fins because it whistles too much. So they came in and they put dampers on some of the other unit, on some of the other lines, forcing more air that way, which solved the problem in one way, but that does put more load on the system because now you're, instead of it just going free where it wants to go, you're saying, don't go here, don't go here, and forcing it to go through a certain spot. So that's not great, and that's not a good flex duct install. So I guess my point is, for the video, is flex duct a good product? It can be, depending on how it's installed. Is rigid duct a good product? It can be, depending on how it's installed. Here is what you need to do to make sure that it's a good install. Most people nowadays are doing a duct leakage test. They're putting a blower on the ductwork and they're seeing how much of the air going in is coming out where we want it to come out. And if it's leaking in between, you'll fail. What that doesn't show you is, if we blow air in here, is the amount of air that we want coming out at all of the different places what we want it to be. This is how you fix that. You make sure that you design the system from the beginning. So you do a manual J at a minimum, or if you're an HVAC designer, comment below on everything that you do because it can get pretty involved. You figure out the loads that are required and you figure out the cooling and the heating that's required in every single room, and then you design a system and then you build that system based off the design. But here's what nobody does. Almost nobody does. Nobody commissions the system. Nobody comes back in on a ducted system and says, okay, this is how much we needed for this room. Are we actually getting that much air to this room? It's a cheap test, but it's another test that it takes to make sure that it's done right. If you're wanting to look for a workaround where you don't have to have somebody come in and test it again, you can put dampers on the plenum from the beginning, and then you're able to adjust it just based off of comfort. And if you have a FLIR camera or a thermal camera, you can look at thermals or whatever. Mostly, I mean, your body's really receptive to changes in heat. So if you're getting hot, it's probably hot. And if you have dampers from the beginning, you can adjust it. But that still doesn't fix the underlying causes. If you've pinched it off from a poor install and you don't know it until everything has drywall on it and it's all covered up, there's not a whole lot you can do economically at that point. But if you test the system while you're still building the house, now you'll have drywall on by the time you're commissioning it, but you can repair it so much easier before everybody's moved in than after, and you know exactly where all of the ducts are versus 2 years later of like, man, where did that go through, and you're trying to find pictures. So long story short, whichever you use, flex or rigid, make sure you design the system, make sure that you test the system, and then make sure you have some adjustability on that system so that if the actuals doesn't meet the designs, you're able to do something about it. Thanks so much for watching. Thanks for being up here in this hot little attic with me, looking around all of these columns and stuff. Comment below with any of your comments, whether you love flex, hate flex, all that stuff. That makes some great comments. Subscribe if we've earned it. Like the video if you liked it. Go follow us over on Instagram, Smith House Co. and Jordan Smith Builds. And if you want consulting work, go over to Smith House Co. Consulting. Find me over there. We'll chat. Thanks so much for watching. We'll talk to you next time on Smith House.